Hi, this is Brian from Worldwide Stereo. In today's video, I'll be reviewing SVS's brand new 1000 Pro Series subwoofers, the SB-1000 Pro and the PB-1000 Pro. Let's talk a little bit about SVS. They're from Youngstown, Ohio. The SVS mission is to re-energize people's desires for awesome sound by bringing passion, fun, and expertise back into the mix. I had the pleasure to chat with a few members of their team, and that energizing philosophy was apparent during our discussion. They're designing products to fit your space and your budget without compromise to the experience. When they're designing and testing, their aha moment is when they stop being critical and listening for flaws and they start enjoying themselves. The new 1000 Pro series directly replaces the old 1000 series. They wanted to make a reference quality subwoofer at an accessible price. What did SVS do between the generations? They put in a better amplification unit with MOSFET outputs. They created a specially designed 12-inch woofer now for both units. The ported unit upgraded itself from a 10-inch to a 12-inch driver and also added an additional port in the front, as well as a 325-watt digital amplifier, which makes them relatively light. Even though this looks like it's big and cumbersome, it's not too terrible to lift up by yourself. The PB-1000 Pro comes in at 42.5 pounds, while the SB-1000 Pro comes in at 26.1 pounds. The PB-1000 Pro comes in black ash. The SB-1000 is available in black ash, but is also available in piano gloss black and piano gloss white. The connections are identical. There are stereo RCA inputs, stereo high-level inputs, and there's a USB. Now, the point of the USB is to provide a convenient power source to SVS's SoundPath wireless adapter. This lets you set up the sub in the best position in your room without having to run a wire, which sometimes you just can't. The SB-1000 Pro is their sealed cabinet unit. It's roughly 13 inches, a little bit deeper, a little bit taller, but it's a 13-inch cube. It's small and compact, but it packs a big punch. It's meant to be their more musical, more exact subwoofer, so it has a really good transient response and a real dynamic range. So when that bass note hits, it really hits when you want it to, and it rolls off when you need it to. So the PB-1000 Pro is their ported unit. So it's a slightly larger box. It's going to have a better bass extension, and it's going to play lower, louder than the sealed unit is capable of doing. But it adds that real extra oomph when you're going for that low end sound. So really great in a home theater environment, that kind of application where it really wants to make a statement. So when I was testing in my environment, I used a pair of nice musical bookshelf speakers. I used a 75-watt integrated amplifier. It has a subwoofer output, but it doesn't have any bass management in the actual amplifier itself, which was great for testing these subwoofers in particular, because it allowed me to use the SVS app to really tune them to the room for what I wanted to test and what I wanted to listen to. So when using the app, setup is a breeze. Because you're no longer fiddling with the back of the subwoofer. You're in your listening position. You're not hunched over in a corner with a flashlight trying to figure out, is my crossover at 60 hertz or is it 80 hertz? Where's my volume at? You're taking the guesswork out of things. You're also able to make like on-the-fly changes. So you can say, okay, does this speaker sound better with a 50 hertz crossover, or is it better at a 60 hertz crossover? What am I hearing? Is the volume going to be too loud, or is it going to be too low? When does the subwoofer start overcoming what I'm listening to? The app actually allows you to create presets. So if I wanted to have a setup for a movie where I wanted them to be loud and rumbly, and I really want them to kind of overtake the experience, I can do that. If I want to set it to a different state when I'm listening to music, I can change the crossover and maybe turn the volume down so they're not overtaking my speakers, and they kind of meld better into the experience. Or there's a late night mode that I could create. It's not really labeled late night, but I could label it late night because the app gives me the ability to say, okay, preset 3 equals late night, which means the subwoofers are turned down so that I'm at least experiencing them. I can hear them, but it's not rattling and shaking and annoying other people either in my house or outside the house. During my evaluation, I created a special super bass playlist to really put these through their paces. My intent wasn't to listen to bass heavy tracks because that's the easy way out. I really wanted to listen to something where the low end had impact and really move the music along. I was happy that my neighbors had recently moved out because it really allowed me to rip into testing these subs. I was looking for things that I've been missing because I don't have a subwoofer. So I was looking to see what I was missing when I was listening to music and what I might be missing when I was watching a movie. So everyone can say, hey, when an explosion goes off, that subwoofer is going to make a big difference. However, there are cases where you'll be watching something and that low end note might hit and it creates a more dramatic environment or an eerie mood that might not ordinarily be there because that crucial low end is missing. You're cutting yourself short if you're losing the low end. You know, people spend time and effort to put it in there. And it's one thing that I learned I was missing with what I had set up. If you think about it, it's half the rhythm section. So, you know, I could be missing a half the band. I found the SB-1000 Pro fit what I needed. It fit my space better because you can see the size difference between them. I had a smaller range in my listening area, so I don't have room for larger components. It really fit what my need was. It was just something more musical. I wanted to set it up in my listening area, not to my television. So I wanted something that was going to be more dynamic when it came to music. So that's why I leaned towards the SB-1000 Pro. Now, would I set up the PB-1000 Pro with my television? Absolutely. Fortunately, I don't have a surround sound setup yet. Thank you for joining me for a review of the all new SVS 1000 Pro series subwoofers. For more information on getting the most out of your subwoofer, check out our subwoofer calibration tutorial linked in our description. And you can learn more about these products online at worldwidestereo.com. Or if you're in the area, you can stop by our showrooms in Ardmore or Montgomeryville, PA. We offer 60-day returns, free shipping on all orders, and we're authorized dealers for everything we sell. If you have any comments or questions, you can leave them in the comment section below, or you can call or email us at any time. Don't forget to keep up with our latest videos, subscribe to our YouTube channel, and hit that notification bell. This is Brian from Worldwide Stereo. I'll see you next time.